Good morning. I have a wonderful presentation ready for you today about the research and development of hormonal birth control. Now, before hormonal birth control, we, as women, only had douches, which we know today don't work, and we also had condoms, which we know that it is a male-controlled birth control. A woman named Margaret Sanger wanted something different. She wanted something that was easy to take, would be more effective, and would also be female controlled. It took her a long time, in fact, till she was 72 years old, to finally invent the pill that would change society as a whole. It all started out when she met a man named Gregory Pincus at a dinner, and he was a medical expert on human reproduction. And he told her that he was going to be able to make this magical pill of hers. So as the founder of Planned Parenthood, she was able to come up with a fund for his research. And in her lifetime, she finally saw the legacy of the pill that she had been waiting for her whole life. And so today I'm going to talk to you about exactly how this pill was researched and how it works in the human body. And I would have a picture of it up here somewhere. Anyways, there's a gland located in your brain called the pituitary, also called the master gland, which also controls different hormones that go out throughout your body. And in women, the ones that are connected to reproduction are, ovulation specifically, are LH and LSH, which are released after menstruation or the period. After a woman's period is done, the brain releases these two hormones, and as the hormones are circulated throughout the blood, this tells the ovaries to start making eggs and releasing them. That's the process of ovulation. After the egg is released, estrogen is released from the ovaries, telling the brain to stop releasing these two hormones. After the brain stops releasing LH and LSH, then ovulation stops and menstruation begins. Now, when we started researching a drug called progesterone, it wasn't intended for as a contraceptive. It was intended as use for making menstruation less painful for women. But when Gregory Pincus noticed that it would stop the ovulation in mice, he discovered that maybe this could work for women as well. And so he told Miss Margaret Sanger about his discovery, and she gave him, with the help of another woman named Catherine McCormick, an heiress, gave him $40,000 for his research, which at the time was a very large sum of money. And so with this money, he conducted many human experiments with progesterone and found that they worked. They had stopped ovulation. And it did this by actually stopping the production of this LH and LSH. And also today, now that it's been more developed, the progesterone has been paired up with estrogen to regulate the menstruation. But mostly the active drug is the progesterone, which would stop these hormones from actually like coming out of the pituitary gland, which stops ovulation altogether. There are also different forms of hormonal birth control today, which also change the lining of the uterus. And this makes it a double form of protection. By changing the lining of the uterus, you make it so that even if an egg did get implanted, there would be no way for it to develop. This unfortunately means that if should an egg come out of the ovary, it might be implanted into the fallopian tube, which would cause a dangerous form of pregnancy. So this was important. This was important because at the time, there was many political and religious views about contraceptives that were not very open to the sexuality of women. People believed that women should be, they should be pure, they should maintain their chastity until marriage. They were supposed to be taking care of the kids and the husband at the house. The husband was more important than the college career. And that's just what developed this view that the government or even religion had any business to do with women's bodies. And Margaret Sanger spent her whole life making sure that this idea that religion or government could interfere with the reproductive process of women was crumbled. She wanted to make sure that women would have the freedom to control whether they had kids or not. And unfortunately, Margaret Sanger did believe in eugenics, which is the belief that we should be making a more perfect race. And her way of doing this, unfortunately, was to build this contraceptive and say that it was for so that dumb people couldn't reproduce. And by dumb people, she unfortunately meant people of color. And that's something that Planned Parenthood tries to hide, but it is an unfortunate truth. But out of this unfortunate truth, we have come to experience this new form of medicine that has given freedom of sexuality and safety, most of all, to women.